Drama in the first as a very short-priced Envoy Alan tipped up. ITV mentioned that Black Bow had the same colours as Florida Pearl. There's another connection, I believe, with Florida Pearl. In December 1998, he was running at Leperton at Christmas, and before the race, I thought, would he stay 3 miles or not? He just won the RSA Chase and was a favourite for next March's Gold Cup. And we found out whether he stayed 3 miles or not. And either I thought, either he would or he wouldn't, obviously. The only one thing that would leave it up to doubt is if he fell. I think exactly what happened to Florida Pearl. And after the race, I read in possibly Sporting Life, Racing Post, Odds On magazine, I'm not quite sure where it was now, just after then, that the issue with Florida Pearl is he never made a mistake. And having made a mistake, he didn't know what to do. And Florida Pearl never fell ever again. And that's an issue here, I think, with Envoy Alan. He didn't know what to do after making a mistake. And it's interesting to see what happens in the future. There's options for him, say, for example, Aintree, Fairhouse and Punchestown, who he might run. So will he run the rest of the season? I don't know. It'd be nice to see him back over fences and see if he's learned from his mistake. My own bet, Fousey Raffles ran well enough for second. Fousey Raffles ran well enough, staying on for second place. Never rode towards the end, looked like he was going to win. The second race to win for Mrs. Milner. Apparently, according to ITV, named actually after James Milner in a way. There's a quite well-known Twitter account called Boring James Milner. Might be connected with that, I'm not sure. Easy enough win for the horse. My outside tip, I have to say, never really was that glad he won off SP 125-1 Perfect Man. Racing Post commented when he just say always towards the rear, never got on terms. It was a little lucky. He had a couple of issues with fallers and been slightly hampered. But he was never, I mean, to be fair, he came 17th. He was never really going to be much closer than that, I feel. Although he only just finished behind Imperial Alcazar, who was 11-2, so he didn't. So he wasn't necessarily, certainly not the most disappointing horse in the race. I think Alaho showed why the Ryanair Chase, officially the Festival Trophy Chase, is an important race for the Festival. There's been arguments that it shouldn't be there. We should just have a Champion Chase for a Gold Cup and nothing else in between at a Championship level. I think that's a mistake. I read a rather daft comment by someone on Twitter, well, I've given a debate about this, saying, was it either a 2 mile or a 3 miler? Well, I don't know about you. I don't remember the Gold Cup losing 2.5 furlongs of its distance. If a Gold Cup was actually a 3 mile race, then Wayward Lad and Florida Pearl would have won it. But it isn't. And Allo was absolutely fantastic. A brilliant performance, a brilliant ride to Mitchell Blackmore, took them all out totally. Miles Kalashnikov, maybe slightly lucky, you could argue not to be placed. As Tornado Flyer, frankly, just picked up the pieces, and Kalashnikov was making an effort to win. He was always seemed to be winning along, though, was never seen it going to win, maybe unlucky not to be placed. But then again, Min had exactly the same issue, was ridden to try and actually chase after Alaho, and eventually he's pulled up after falling back quickly. So you argue that if Min hadn't chased after Alaho, that may have fallen. Min may have finished ahead of Kalashnikov and Tornado Flyer as well anyway. Now the interesting question here, so I've read a comment on Twitter about whether the Golden Miller Chase, the opening race on the card, should actually remain. And I, after reading that, was a bit doubtful actually whether it should remain. I'm a fan of it as I say intermediate races. In terms of Ryanair Chase, I think certainly think that is an important race to hold. But do you really need a championship level sort of novice chase at 2 miles, 2 mile 4, 3 miles, and now 3 mile 6 instead of a 4 miler, which the National Challenge Cup has now lost 2 of its furlongs last year? And I'm not convinced you do. There are 2 intermediate Grade 1 Novice Chases elsewhere, Manifesto Chase at Aintree and Vasiliar's Novices Chase at Sandown. I do wonder if any of these 3 races should exist in their current form, as I'm not sure they actually serve any purpose. As I've said probably last year on a few other occasions, I actually would like to see a Ryanair type hurdle at Cheltenham Festival and put the Stairs Hurdle up to 3 miles 2, make it so the Stairs Hurdle at 3 miles 2 furlongs would be a proper staying test, and it isn't always. And you have a 2 mile 5 hurdler and a 3 mile 2, and I think that would actually help the festival myself. But I think I'm not sure there's any great groundswell support for that idea. Flooring Porter with the Stairs Hurdle, and as can be seen, I actually did have a bet on it anti-post. In fact, it's strange, I've had a bet on all 5 championship races you see anti-post. And Flooring Porter is the only one of the 5 horses who actually turned up to the race. So running in, I got a better Appletard, but sadly for the wrong race. It's a good performance from a horse running on from the front. Paisley Park, now it always seemed a little bit struggling out-paced. Ran on well who have yet to enter, get third place. My tip, Little Rockefeller, is, you know, Cheltenham Festival regular. What might be worth a betting outside price of the race? I wasn't sure about actually any horses particularly. Anyone well enough for a while, but never really was good enough anymore. Shutner winning the fifth race, the Plate. I stood before the old name of a Marmee or Fleet it used to have. And of course, great for the connections, winning the Moor Battle Hurdle at Kelso and going on to win this race for £100,000 bonus. There was controversy early in the season when he won in a Tipperary Hurdle early in July, with a jockey being banned for 21 days and a horse banned for 60 days, as it was felt he was a non-trier. So, a bit of controversy there. But of course, a lot of great money for the connections of the horse winning both races. And obviously, very, very ecstatic groom, which is good to see on ITV Racing. Tell Me Something Girl winning the Dorwood Hurdle. And incredibly, another win there for Rachel Blackmore. And I last looked on Betfair for odds of the best rider for the festival. And she's now 10-1 on for that. It's also been well supported, apparently, for an Irish Sports Award. And I certainly hope she gets that. And it doesn't only just seem a brilliant rider, never mind male or female, but also seems very confident in with the media, and I think is a great asset to horse racing in many ways. And certainly, I think has a long career, not just as a rider. I think if you want to go to media loans after you retire, like people like AP McCoy and Ruby Walsh, I think she'd do very well at it. And finally, the Folk Warwin Kimure Chase, won by Mount Ida under Jack Kennedy, came for a mile off the pace. And he looked, I should say, probably just confidently ridden, certainly, but cruised home. And it was an easy win in the end. And you could tell him home straight he was going to win. And unless something dramatic happened, and he didn't. And the horse was a very impressive win in the end. And that's the end of day three.